fans were going nuts here in Atlanta and on the campus of U of L and around the city of Louisville. Erica Coghill caught up with some of them back home.
Yeah, Rick, Fred, I'm right outside of U of L's campus, and as people have been walking and driving by, they've been yelling, "Go Cards!" A lot of fans beaming with pride tonight after that close game. I think it's safe to say tonight the Cards were the ones doing the shocking. For a good part of the game, Cards fans were fearing the Shockers.
We were down by 12. I thought we would lose.
And losing was something some refused to witness. A game so close it was enough to give you a card attack.
Oh my God, it could not be any closer. It was a nail breaker. I don't have any nails left. Oh my God, they took it to the last second.
I knew after watching how we played throughout the season, I knew we'd kind of come through in the end. It's kind of, we're a second-half team.
Can't imagine being that thing, that's all. You know what I'm saying? Cards, number one, all day. Let's go, baby. Let's go, baby.
And the fans did their thing.
I can't talk.
Even cheering for those off the court. Where, fans say, a force that fueled the final score.
Watching his emotions at the end, watching him crying and trying to keep his emotions together for everyone, like, you knew that everyone on that floor was trying to win it for him.
With where and everything happening, if we don't win this year, I don't know when we would.
Hopefully they play better than the way that they played at the first half of this game and that they're able to bring it home.
They're destined to win.
Yeah.
It's been 26 years. We're going to win it all. We're going to win it all. We're going to win it all, baby.
And some people here in Louisville tonight have been celebrating a little too hard. Police tell us they've had to make 6 arrests. That was at last check. One of those for menacing and the others for those were for disorderly conduct. And police say right now at this point, most of the issues are just traffic related, but they're continuing to monitor all of those celebrations tonight. Reporting live outside of U of L's campus, I'm Erica Coghill, WLKY News.